students, good morning all. I think all are good. So today I am going to explain the block diagram reduction problems. So now you see, using a block diagram reduction technique, find closed loop transfer function of the system. So before going to solve this problem, you must know what is meant by transfer function. This is an important 2-mark question also. So transfer function is nothing but Laplace transform of output divided by Laplace transform of input, all the initial conditions are zero. So therefore, for this system also, we are going to find out the transfer function. So transfer function is nothing but C divided by R. Or otherwise, the C is nothing but response or output. So this we can represent C of S. This we can represent it as C of S. C of S. Then the R is nothing but input, so that is represented as R of S. So therefore, we can write the transfer function is equal to C of S divided by R of S. Okay. Now, so this is a system. Then you have to think which step we have to do first. So immediately, you see this block diagram. In between G2 and G3, we are having one branch point. Okay, suppose if you are not having this branch point here now, then these two blocks are connected in cascade. Immediately we can reduce this block. But here in between these two blocks we are having a branch point. So we have to move this branch point after the block or before the block. So that is your choice. But here what I am going to do now, so I am going to move this branch point before the block G2. Before the block G2. Once if you move this branch point before the block now, then automatically these two blocks are connected in cascade. Then next this G4 block is connected in parallel with this forward path. So that is a second step. Okay, now we will discuss one by one. So first one, moving the branch point before the block G2. So what happened? So in the feedback path, I am having the value is H1. If you are moving this branch point before the block now, then feedback path gain into this forward path gain. So that's why H1 into G2. The next, this G2 and G3 are connected in cascade. So that is the next step. Okay. So therefore, now I am combined this G2 and G3. So cascade means you have to multiply. The next what I told you, this G4 block is connected in parallel. So therefore, I am added this G4. Why am I putting a plus polarity? Here you see the polarity is plus. So that's why plus G4. So reduction of this two, we can get G2, G3 plus G4. Okay. Then next, after this, what you have to do? You have to think. So here next step is, so here I am having the branch point. So this branch point I am going to move after this block. Once if you are moving this branch point after this block now, this feedback path divided by this forward path gain. So therefore you are getting the expression like this. G2, G3. So you are having same value. G2, G3 plus G4. So here you are having the feedback path H2. Then this branch point only I am moved after this block. So therefore here H1 G2 divided by G2 G3 plus G4. Okay. Then the remaining blocks you have to draw as it is. After this you have to do this elimination of this feedback loop. Okay. So here the loop is negative feedback. So therefore first you have to eliminate. So here the forward path gain is G2, G3 plus G4 divided by 1 plus G2, G3 plus G4 into the feedback element is H2. So therefore we are getting the expression like this. Then next what is this? This G1 block is connected in series with this block or cascade connection. So cascade means what you have to do? You have to multiply. Okay, so that thing only I did here, you see. G1 into G2, G3 plus G4 divided by 1 plus G2, G3 plus G4 into H2. Okay. So, after that, we have to eliminate this loop. Okay. So here both the loops are negative feedback. So therefore you have to eliminate. So first I am eliminating the first feedback loop. So here you see the forward path gain is G1 into G2 G3 plus G4 divided by 1 plus G2 G3 plus G4 into H2 divided by 1 plus forward path gain into feedback path gain. Then after that you have to reduce this. Then finally you will get G1 into G2 G3 plus G4 divided by 1 plus G2 G3 plus G4 into H2 plus G1 G2 into H1. So this is the value for this block. Then after that we have to eliminate this unity feedback path. Okay. So unity means the feedback path element is 1. Okay. So that value only I am substituted here. Forward path gain divided by forward path gain into feedback element. So feedback element is 1. Then after that you have to simplify. Once if you are simplifying now, then you will get the transfer function C by R is equal to G1 G2 G3 plus G1 into G4 divided by 1 plus G2 G3 H2 plus G4 H2 plus G1 G2 into H1 plus G1 G2 G3 plus G1 into G4. So this is the transfer function for the given system. Thank you all.